Hello. Who are you? Doesn't matter. Welcome. You're safe with me. I'll be right here, nice and close, so I can speak without alerting the others. Let me tell you about Senua. Her story has already come to an end, but now it begins anew.
What's happening?
It's breathing.
Dead. It's breathing.
It's breathing.
He knows. He knows she's getting closer.
He can feel her coming closer.
She's getting
journey deep into darkness. There will be no more stories after this one.
What is she doing?
Why is she doing this?
They're watching.
Why doesn't she turn back?
She's doing this for him. She wants to rescue him.
He's already dead.
I can feel you coming.
Shh.
Coming.
Quiet.
Oh, how rude of me. I never told you of the others. You hear them too, right? They've been around ever since the tragedy. Well, that's not quite true. Some are old, some are new, but they've changed. I think the darkness changed them, just like it changed her.
Look around you. Can you see them? Over there.
Why isn't she looking?
Why aren't you looking?
He's in hell high.
Look. Up ahead.
In hell high.
You see it too?
You promised you gave me.
Yes. It is real after all. She's finally arrived in the land of mist and fog. The place the Northmen call hell.
Can you see them? Can you see them? They're going to do that to you.
They're watching.
Stop.
Can you feel them watching? They're watching her.
What is she thinking? I can tell you. She's afraid. Wouldn't you be? You'd think she would get used to it by now after so many years. But the darkness, it just builds onto itself, growing stronger, towering over her. You might try and ignore it. Turn away. But it's always there, just out of sight, where you're most vulnerable. It's like it knows that just enough light is all you need to see its suffocating power. You might think she's brave to go on this journey on her own, but it isn't bravery that drives her. Bravery only means something to those afraid of death. Then it was fear runs far, far deeper.
No going back.
You can't do it.
Fenua pushes away a world that conspired to cause so much suffering. There's nothing to go back to, and worse to look forward to. Why don't you join us? Maybe you too have a part to play in this story.
To look to see.
Why isn't she focusing?
She needs to focus now.
Do not forget my story, Senua. Because your darkness comes from hell. Do not forget my story, Senua. Because your darkness comes from hell, and your fate lies there. They say the burning of a corpse will take you straight to Hela's gate, but gods and the living will follow this path. You must leave the Isles of Orkney across the Eastern Sea and find a road that leads north and down through deep, dark valleys. After 9 nights of riding, you will follow a great river and will find a bridge covered in gold. The path to Helheim goes from there, across the River of Knives that flows from the dark world of Niflheim. Knives across which lies the halls of hell, the place they call Helheim. There's no doubt about
it.
The source of the darkness is in Helheim.
You'll never find him.
And the goddess Hela holds his soul there. Her dear beloved, Dillian.
What is she doing? Why is she doing this?
Why doesn't she turn back? She's doing this for him.
She wants to rescue him.
He's already dead.
He's dead. But his soul is in hell.
The bridge to Helheim.
Where are we?
I forget its name. She forgets too. But she does remember that only the dead may cross it. That part wasn't so easy to forget. The old fool said there was a hidden path up to it. Let's see, shall we?
The Northmen speak of nine worlds. The world of men they call Midgard. Sky gods dwell in Asgard. The gods of earth, harvest, wind, and sea dwell in Vanaheim. The good elves dwell in Alfheim. The evil ones dwell in Svartalfheim. The mountain giants dwell in Jotunheim. The fire giants dwell in Muspelheim. Niflheim is the world of ice and darkness. Only the dead dwell in Helheim. And that is where you must travel.
You don't know where you're going.
Come on. Get down.
What's she waiting for?
Why did she do that?
She shouldn't have done it.
She can't go back now.
No, this is it. The hidden path.
Don't kill me.
I'm not one of them.
Don't listen.
I was just hiding. I find I live longer that way.
Don't listen.
I'll never let the bastards catch me again. Never! Wait. Who are you?
It's just a memory.
Truth.
For my tales of the Northmen, they call me Druth, a liar, an old fool. Druth is my truth.
It's good to see you again. You kept your vow.
To guide you in this life and the next, I will tell you my stories of hell. If I may walk with you.
Tell me your stories again, old friend. I'm listening.
The runes seal the gates to hell. Focus your inner eye, and you too will see what's hidden in plain sight.
I can see it with
your mind. Hold it in your mind's eye. Find one like it to open the gate.
She focus.
Take a closer look.
It's near. Focus, and you will find it. Look towards the gate, and the gate will open.
He's not right.
The gate is open. Go through the gate.
Go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it.
Good work.
I'll take you. It's unsafe.
I spent 6 years enslaved in hell, but I watched the Northmen, learnt their ways.
I know you did.
You listened when everyone else laughed. My people paid a heavy price. Carry my stories with you, and together we will make the Northmen feel our fury.
Another voice joins us. She once tried to make them go away. Pretend they weren't real. But what good is that? When we are always here. I guess it's the same with heights. You can stand on the edge.
Don't fall.
Pretend it's going to be okay. But you know that death is near, waiting for you to make that little slip. You can't just wish things away.
The world of the dead is ruled by the giantess, Hela, daughter of Loki. The gods feared her bloodline, bad on her mother's side, and yet much worse on her father's. So, as a child, the Allfather cast her down into Helheim and gave her power over those who die of sickness, age, hardship, and self-slaughter. In all of the nine worlds, only Hela can resurrect the dead. To Hela, your Dillion was sacrificed, and with her you must bargain.
Thank you.
did.
Don't. You did this. Spread towards her head, the seed of the soul, until there is nothing left of her. All of her suffering will have been for nothing. It's just a matter of time. Battles are fought in the mind. That is what Dillian taught her. With every defeat, the dark rot will grow and soon it will take her soul. But for now, at least, she still has control of her mind. And she will fulfill her vow. Whatever the cost. He's not wrong.
Listen to me, Senua. The goddess Hela lies behind the gate to Helheim. To open the gate, you must first face the gods that guard it. The god of fire, Surt, and the god of illusion, Valravn. Spill their blood to open the gate to Helheim and enter the land of the dead.
Gate to Hela, to Dillian,
to his soul. It won't open.
How will she get through?
Why won't it open?
Why can't she open it? She needs to challenge the gods.
She has to fight.
The Northmen say that in the beginning there was nothing but darkness, bitter cold to the north, fiery hot to the south. They say the cold formed ice, which melted from the sparks from the south. The power of the darkness gave life to the dripping ice, and the first giant was born and was named Ymir. The ice continued to drip, and the power of the void gave life to it, and it became a cow whose milk fed the giant. That's right, a cow. But you weren't expecting that. To open the gate, you must first face the gods that guard it. The god of fire, Surt, and the god of illusion, Valravn. Spill their blood to open the gate to Helheim and enter the land of the dead.
Valravn, ancestor of the seers and master of ravens. He hunts his prey with his powers of illusion and feasts on their remains. Follow the path to Valravn and defeat him in battle to earn his mark. The gate to Helheim cannot be opened without it.
Hides the path to Valravn. Don't trust your eyes. Find another way to see the truth. Ymir was a frost giant, a being of darkness, and all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice, Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods, the Old Father. Say that in the beginning there was nothing but darkness. Bitter cold to the north, fiery hot to the south. They say the cold formed ice, which melted from the sparks from the south. The power of the darkness gave life to the dripping ice, and the first giant was born and was named Ymir. The ice continued to drip, and the power of the void gave life to it, and it became a cow whose milk fed the giant. That's right, a cow, but you weren't expecting that.
door. Push it. Push it. Push it. Come on. Come on. Push it. She did. She did it. She did it. She did it.
Close our eyes again and pretend what we saw was never really there.
Valravn's power of illusion comes from ravens, allowing the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Truth.
Look how much it's changed.
Break the seal. Align the ravens with the mark of Valravn.
Another world that looks the same but feels different. An imposter world where the forest itself is watching.
Thank you.
Another gate.
Another gate. You know what to do. Stay back. You have to open it. It's not safe. Don't listen.
To break the seal, align the ravens with the mark of Valravn.
Which ravens?
Where are they?
Can't you see them, Shakes?
The ground. Try to find the ravens.
Line up the ravens.
Line up.
Focus.
not your fault.
Who make it back are forever changed.
She can get up now.
She can get up now.
What's happening?
She can get up now.
How can she get up?
There must be magic.
Dark magic.
A trick.
Raven.
Tricking her.
Raven.
How can she get up?
Bait.
It's him.
Magic draws her closer.
Oh, Raven's magic.
It's not him.
He's helping her.
It's not him.
It's a trick.
She's doing it
on her own.
He's not tricking her. It's magic.
It's an illusion. See the threat. It doesn't mean that it's not already here.
Find your own path.
It's a different way.
You're
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.